from Washington. Congressman, thank you for staying with me.
You're welcome.
Tonight, I want to ask you, what is your reaction to all the GOP rhetoric we've heard on this humanitarian crisis in Texas over immigration?
Well, Al, it's like everything else. If the president hit a home run, the Republicans would say he lost the ball. They simply will never give him credit for anything that he does. He has put up budgets, and they have stalled them and blocked them for all this time to have people to do this. He now comes forward with a bill that says exactly what they've been talking about, and they reject it and say, well, it's not enough or it's too late. Or it's, they simply will not work with the president. They would rather have the problem than solve it. That's what's really going on here.
Now, he was greeted at the airport on the tarmac by Governor Rick Perry, who at first said he wasn't going to greet him. Then he did after he got the meeting he wanted. But he's also raised that there were ulterior motives, raising some really, in my opinion, strange conspiracy theories around the immigration crisis and the president. How do you read what Perry is doing here, Congressman?
Perry's getting ready to run for president, and he's going to say anything he thinks will help get him down the road. You have to remember, again, it's by your deeds ye shall know them. He has refused to take Medicaid, and he's got hundreds of thousands of people in Texas who do not have health care, and yet he's given these stories about the president wants these kids to come up here and get shuffled around, and he's got an all crazy theory. Nothing about Rick Perry made sense, and people are seeing it right on television.
I'm going to have to take a quick break. We're waiting on President Obama to come out and make a statement in Dallas after that meeting. Congressman, stay with me. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Okay.
The Cadillac Summer Collection is here.